Hi students, this is Ajita. In this video, you will learn about content words and function words with few examples. Introduction. Each word in English belongs to one of the 8 parts of speech. Each word is also either a content word or a function word. Let's think about what these 2 types mean. Content words. Content words convey information and meaning. These are usually nouns, verbs, adjectives, adverbs. These are the most important content words. Other content words are negatives, question words, and demonstrative pronouns. Nouns. These words are used to identify any of a class of people, places, animals or things. Examples of nouns. Name of people. Anita, Raju, Ram, Sita. A name of places. Forest, zoo, school, playground. A name of animals. Elephant, dog, fox, tiger. A name of things. Mobile, telephone, table, chair. These are the few examples of nouns. Verbs. These words are used to describe an action, state, or occurrence. Almost every sentence requires a verb. For example, study, paint, talk, help, swim, think, look, play. These are the few examples of verbs. Adjectives. These are words that describe or modify a noun or pronoun. For example, sad, big, weak, cold, bitter, clean, colorful, shiny. These are the few examples of adjectives. Now let's see adverbs. These are words or phrases that modify or qualify an adjective, verb, or other adverb. Let's see some examples of adverbs. Outside, quietly, often, already, nowhere, just, yesterday, anywhere, correctly. These are the few examples of adverbs. Negatives. These are the words or phrases that show you reject or disagree with something. For example, can't, don't, won't, isn't, etc. These are the few examples of negatives. Words like no, not, never, and nobody are negatives too. Let's see the question words. These words are used to frame or ask a question. Let's see some examples of question words. What, who, where, when, why. These are the few examples of question words. Demonstrative pronouns. These are the words that point to specific things. For example, this, that, these, those. These are the examples of demonstrative pronouns. Let's see the function words. These words help us to connect important information and for understanding, but they add little meaning. These include auxiliary verbs, prepositions, articles, conjunctions, and pronouns. Auxiliary verbs. These verbs are used in forming the tenses, moods, and voices of other verbs. Let's see the examples of auxiliary verbs. Is, am, are, was, were, etc. Prepositions. Words or phrases that connect a noun or pronoun to a verb or adjective in a sentence. Let's see the examples of prepositions. About, above, according to, across, against, ahead of. These are the few examples of prepositions. Here you can see a list of prepositions. Articles. These are words that define a noun as a specific or unspecific. Examples: a or an, and the. Conjunctions. These are words that join together other words, phrases, clauses, or sentences. Let's see the examples of conjunctions. Though, and, however, after, but, until, yet, since, before, so, because, while. These are the few examples of conjunctions. Let's see pronouns. Pronouns are words used as substitutes for nouns or noun phrases. For example, I, you, he, she, it, we, they. These are the few examples of pronouns. Conclusion. Knowing the difference between content and function words is important because content words are stressed in conversation in English. Function words are non-stressed. In other words, function words are not emphasized in speech while content words are highlighted. Thank you. Like, share, and subscribe.